talk about Christmas. I'm here to talk about the posting I put up yesterday, actually this morning. And I want you to describe in one word what's next for you in life. And I have some great responses. Thank you to everybody who responded. Here's what I'm looking for. Think of the one word that says, this is what's next for me. So Joe Rooney, who is one of my friends, Joe, love you, bud. One of the things I want you to think about is when you think of the next word of what's next for you, think of something that's going to crystallize in your mind that is going to make you say, okay, I'm going to do this. Like for me, it's breakthrough, right? Breakthrough to me means nothing's going to stop me from getting through my glass ceiling of life. And everyone's got a glass ceiling. Everyone has one. I have one. You have one. We all have one. But I want you to think of that one word. Someone said peace. Now, peace is great. It's a good warm and fuzzy word, but it's bullshit. I want you to tell me what's the one word that's going to describe what's next for you in business and in life. Okay. Mine is breakthrough. Breakthrough both in my personal life. I got to get back on my consistent workout schedule. There's a bunch of things I have to do. And my other one is kind of no excuses. So I want you to think about that. And for everyone who responded in the chat, thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Big what's up to everyone who's joined here on the live feed. So think of that one word. My sister said peace. So Helene, love you. Thank you for responding. I know Daisy said bliss. Joe Rooney said success. And I want you to just think about that word because I think it's super duper. And Greg Walker's in the house. Make sure you follow Greg. Greg is a fantastic speaker, by the way. This guy just crushes it everywhere. He's hanging out with Les Brown. I'm a little jelly, just a little bit. Anyway, so think of what that word is. For some of you, it could be success. But you need to ask yourself this question. What does success mean to you? Like success for me could be I got to the gym today. Success for someone else could be, hey, I didn't have a drink today. Right? I know friends of mine that are in the program. It says, hey, success for me is, hey, I didn't take drugs today. I didn't do something that was that would dishonor my family or dishonor my friends. Success means that, hey, I got this project finished at my job. Success means, hey, I've been working on this placement and I'm a recruiter and I finally got it placed and I'm ready for the next one. Right? For some of you, it could be success could mean, hey, listen, I didn't have that seventh cookie. It could mean so many different things. So we have success. We have bliss. My sister says peace. I say breakthrough. I want you to think about what's that one word that's going to get you to say, okay, I've done this. You know, I ran into an old friend from Mount Vernon today. It's interesting. So for my Mount Vernon friends here, I had a really great interaction with a friend of mine named Glenn Capello. Somebody I've known for many, many years. He's a few years older than me. He was that guy in Mount Vernon who had that car, and he was the car guy and the music guy. We were just kind of reminiscing about things. And the one word that we talked about was bond, right? So what does bond mean for you? Maybe you want to bond with your kids, bond with your spouse, bond with your friends, right? Think about what that one word means to you. Put it here in the comments. And here's the thing. It's not for me, guys. It's for all of us to share. I want everyone to think about what their one word is because your one word could spark someone else's one word, right? I always talk about you're the average of the five people you hang out with. And it doesn't happen overnight. Let's talk about that. So the five people you hang out with on a regular basis, they absolutely influence your life. And let me tell you why that is. Because subconsciously, when you're hanging around with other people, things get into your head. I mean, I don't know the scientific words, and I call them the big boy, big girl words to describe. I'm giving you the Anthony Conklin view of the world. But I can tell you from experience, the people I hung out with 10 years ago are not the people I'm hanging out with today. And it's not because they're bad people. They're just not part of my present and not part of my future. If you're hanging around with people that are stopping you or telling you, hey, you shouldn't really do that. Hey, you should take some time off. Hey, you get too wrapped up in this. You get too wrapped up in that. You know, I think you're really working too hard. I think you go to the gym too much. I think you're too much of a healthy eater. Eventually, that's going to get into your head and that's going to mess up your one word. So if your one word for 2020, okay, as we end a decade and start a new one, if your word is success, what does success mean to you? How about love? What does love mean to you? Is it love of life, love of family, love your spouse, love your kids? How about love yourself? You know, I know that sounds all, you know, kind of mushy and soft, but If you don't love yourself, listen to me, guys. If you don't love yourself, you can't love anybody, right? So if love is your word, describe what love means to you. Love of family, I said family, spouse, friends, kids. How about love of your job, love of your career? How about the love of helping yourself be better for yourself so you can be better for other people? How about that? Think about that for a second. Like, I loved music and I still love music, right? But it's a part of my life. It's one of the things I love, right? I love my wife. I love my kids. I know what I love about me? I love my energy. That's something I'm so blessed and grateful for. You know, think about this one word. I'm going to tell you a really quick story and I'm going to end this live stream. I'm going to tell you a really quick story, guys. This is super important. I just did a video on Instagram. And I want you to, I'll kind of take you through the story real quick and then I'll post up the video. And this is super important. If you liked it, please put a little comment here and share it out with some of your friends. Here's the thing. You're trying to break through. You're trying to accomplish your goal in life. And what happens is you kind of like notch these excuses in your belt, right? You got like this 50 holes in your belt, and I call them excuses, okay? So you have these lists of excuses. I don't have enough money. I'm too old. I should have done it 20 years ago. I don't have enough money. Next year, next month, next week, tomorrow, you got these lists of excuses. And those excuses could come from your head and your subconscious. They could come from the people you hang around with every single day. Here's the thing. In order for you to accomplish your goals today, tomorrow, next week, next month, next decade, next 30 years of your life, is you have to focus on doing the work. Here's what I do to try to get the negativity out of my head as I'm focusing on executing to get my one goal done for next year. You gotta stand guard at the door of your mind and you have to eliminate the negativity. And it might come from some of your family members. It might come from your neighbors. It might come from your friends. It might come from people who you really think you love and care about and you spent all of your life with. You need to eliminate the negativity by pushing that away from you and just letting it go in its own direction. Here's what I do. Instead of praying for things, you know what happens when people pray? You know who told me this? I went to Molino's restaurant the other day, and Rusty, who's she's like 84 years old. She said something to me that stuck in my head the other night. I celebrated my birthday a few nights ago, and my wife and I went there for dinner. Rusty said to me, she goes, you know, everybody prays for things to happen. You ever notice when things are really bad, you pray, oh God, please make it better. Go God, God, God. Don't pray to God to make things better. Don't. You make it better, and God says, okay, you're ready for it. Don't pray to make things better. Here, this hit me right here. Pray for what you already have and thank God for where you are. It's called sitting in gratitude. Sit in gratitude. That just blows my mind. If you can sit in gratitude for 5 minutes a day and just say, God, thank you for today. Thank you for the blessings of good health. Thank you for the blessings of family. Thank you for the blessings of children. Thank you for the blessings of my spouse, my family, my friends, my career, my job, my home. Just be grateful for what you have. Nothing else matters. So what's that one word, guys? I know I kind of went off on a tangent. What's that one word that you want to write down today, December 14th, 2019? What's the one word that's going to describe what you're going to do to accomplish that one word goal, right? Mine is breakthrough. A few of you said bliss, love, peace, happiness, right? Don't make it soft and fuzzy. Write it down and say, I am going to freaking do this, 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 and just write, I'm going to do all these things to accomplish that goal. Life and business. Write it down, share it out. Don't be bashful. This is not for me. This is for you. I'm going to benefit from you guys, but this is for you. Mine is breakthrough, and I'll keep you posted. Hope you guys, did you find this helpful? Because I can't see the comments. I hope you found this helpful. If you did, great. If you didn't, then you're not part of my tribe. I'm grateful for you. Thank you for allowing me to share a few minutes with you. Hope you write down that one word. I hope you accomplish your goals. I hope you have your breakthrough. I hope whatever that word is, that you accomplish it. Sending you love, passion, and all kinds of excitement your way. I hope you have a fantastic weekend. And remember, you have greatness within you. You do. You are meant for greatness. Not for mediocrity. Not for anything else. And by the way, here's one more quote. Mediocre people hate high performers, and high performers hate mediocre people. Don't be a mediocre person, be a high performer. I love you guys. Thank you so much. Don't forget, every day, live with passion. Thank you so much, guys.